Hello students, today we are going to learn about designing organic synthesis, in which we are going to learn about protection and deprotection of alcohol functional groups. Myself, Dr. Bhondve Rahul from Department of Chemistry, TC College, Baramati. So friends, in my previous videos, I covered the methyl ether formation and their deprotection. Also, I cover the substituted methyl ethers or acetals. These five substitution or protecting groups we have discussed in previous videos. So if you haven't seen those videos, please go through these videos so you can understand the formation of methyl ethers and these five protecting groups. So today's lecture is totally based on silyl protection in organic synthesis or formation of silyl ethers and their deprotection. Okay, so we will learn about the protection and deprotection of silyl ethers. So what are silyl ethers? It is an organic compound in which silicon atom is covalently bonded to an alkoxy group. Here you can see this is a silicon atom which is covalently bonded to the alkoxy groups. This is also called as silyl ether. Okay, silyl ether is nothing but oxygen and silicon are covalently bonded in a organic compound. So this is called as silyl ethers. So hope you understand the formula of silyl ethers. So let's discuss about formation of silyl ethers. So there are two main strategies for the silylation of alcohols. Firstly, the reaction with silyl chloride, or you can use silyl triplet in presence of hindered base such as amines or organic base. So I have the mechanism for the formation. We have silyl chlorides. This is a trimethyl silyl chloride. And we have alcohol in presence of hindered base like triethyl amine. So this oxygen lone pair will attack on silicon and chlorine will live as a leaving group. This protonated compound is then treated with triethyl amine and it abstracts the proton from the oxygen. Okay, so we get the trimethyl silyl ether. This is called as trimethyl silyl ether and it is a protecting group for alcohol. So this is a salt for our base. This is a very simple mechanism for the protection of alcohols with the help of silyl chloride. So friends, we can use silyl triplets. This is a structure of triplet. We can abbreviate this one as TMS-OTF. Okay, this is a TMS group and this is OTF. So this is a TMS-OTF. The mechanism is same for this triplet. Oxygen lone pair will attack on silicon and this will live as a leaving group and we get the trimethyl silyl ether or protection of alcohol. So this is how protection is carried out. The most common, or I will say most reliable and rapid procedure for the formation of silyl protection is Corey protocol. I think everyone knows the famous scientist E.J. Corey. The team developed the Corey protocol. For the Corey protocol, we need silyl chlorides in presence of imidazole, or I will say alcohols reacted with the silyl chloride and imidazole in presence of or in the DMF to get the silyl protection in good yield. This is called as Corey protocol. So in this, instead of using hindered amines, we are using imidazole as a base. So the mechanism is again similar. Oxygen lone pair will attack on the silicon, chlorine will leave and we get this protonated product. Deprotonation in presence of base. So imidazole will abstract this proton and we get the final silylated or silyl protected alcohols. This is most commonly used procedure for the silyl protection and it is called as Corey protocol. So we learned about the protection. Now we see the commonly used silyl ethers. Friends, there are many silyl ethers or silyl protections are developed, but these five are very commonly used silyl ethers, okay, silyl protecting groups. So first one is TMS, abbreviated as trimethyl silyl ether. Okay, trimethyl silyl is a TMS, trimethyl silyl group, therefore TMS. This is a TS, triethyl silyl, and again the next one is TBDMS. So friends, there is a little bit confusion for this kind of abbreviations because all T are not equal. In the first two example, T stands for tri, But in the third example, this T stands for tertiary. Okay, this T stands for tertiary in third and fourth example. In fifth, it stands for tri. So then don't confuse with the T. You need to remember the structure. TMS means trimethylsilyl and TBDMS means tertiary butyl dimethylsilyl. Okay, tertiary butyl dimethylsilyl. This is the TBDMS, or we can say TBS. The TBDPS is tertiary butyl diphenylsilyl. Okay, tertiary butyl diphenylsilyl. And last one is triisopropylsilyl. Okay, triisopropylsilyl, abbreviated as TIPS. So friends, why they developed so many silyl ether for the protection? One or two are not sufficient? Yes, because if we increase the bulk on the silicon, their stability increases. And if we see the stability order, TMS is the least stable, it is easily deprotected. But as we goes on increasing the bulk on or steric crowding on the silicon, the stability increases. Okay, if in an example, if we have TMS group and TBDPS group, the first TMS will be cleaved or the deprotected. Okay, so this is how they are useful due to their steric crowding. Okay, so the highest stable is TIPS and least stable is TMS in all the condition for the deprotection. So this is how the commonly used silyl ethers are used in organic synthesis for the protection of alcohols. Friends, let's see the silyl deprotection. So silyl can be deprotected in presence of acids, the protic acids, or fluorides such as TBAF, that is tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride, abbreviated as TBAF. So TBAF is commonly used reagent for the deprotection of silyl ethers. As you can see that fluorides have very strong affinity for the silicon, so it will attack on the silicon and leave the OH group or oxygen as a free OH group. Okay, so friends, we can use acids as well as TBAF, or I will say any source of fluoride. Any source of fluoride can deprotect the silyl protection. So you can see the commonly used fluoride source is tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride. This is structure of tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride. This is a source of fluoride which is used for the deprotection of TMS. So let's see the mechanism of deprotection, the acid deprotection and fluoride deprotection. In case of acid deprotection, the O of the oxygen, O of the alcohol is protonated first, and then the water molecule attack on the silicon and it will leave this ROH as a free alcohol. Okay, this will be silyl free alcohol or deprotected from the silyl. In case of fluoride, as already discussed, fluoride have strong affinity for the silicon. The F minus will attack on the silicon and we will get the RO minus or alkoxide. In workup, it abstracts the proton from solvent and we get the ROH. This is how the deprotection mechanism for the silyl deprotection. Okay, so let's see what reagents we use for the silyl deprotection. So in 1970s or 80s, they use camphosulfonic acid, CSA, in methanol. After that, some groups used acetic acid, THF water, and the most commonly used is HF pyridine, basic condition, and TBAF, that is tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride. So tetrabutyl ammonium fluoride is commonly used reagent for the deprotection. For HF, as everyone knows that HF is used for the etching of the glasses, so it is used in plastic containers. Okay, this is how the silyl deprotection is carried out with the help of these reagents. So friends, there are some conditions which help us for the selective deprotection. So if we have two groups, okay, this is a TBS, this is silyl protection, this one also silyl protection, and both the alcohols are secondary alcohols, so their deprotection rate may be similar, but we can deprotect them selectively. In acidic deprotection, less hindered silyl group actually leaves faster. So this one is TBDS, or TBS, that is a tertiary butyl dimethyl silyl. This is a triethyl silyl. That means this is the less hindered, which is cleaved first or faster. Now in the fluoride deprotection, as you know that F minus is electron rich, it will attack on the electron poor silyl groups. So electron poor silyl groups will cleave faster in presence of fluoride reagents. Okay, this is how we can achieve the selective deprotection. Let's see some examples. These are the examples for protection. So these two OH groups are protected in presence of triplets, silyl triplets. TMS OTF is a silyl triplet, and you can see this OH are converted to OTMS OTMS. Similarly, this OH is converted to TMS OTMS in presence of TMS CN. Also, these two OH groups are converted to OTS in presence of TS CL, that is triethyl silyl chloride in presence of pyridine. So this is how the silyl protection is carried out. Let's see some example of deprotections. So for the deprotection, as already discussed, if we have 2% HF or HF in pyridine, the less hindered is first deprotected. This TS is deprotected instead of TBDMS. If we use excess of acid, both this silyl protection will deprotect. There is no doubt in that. So this is example from Texol. There are three TS group, TS, TS and TS, all are deprotected in presence of HF and pyridine. We can see OH, OH and OH group. This is the example of TIPS, which is deprotected in presence of ammonium fluoride. This is another source of fluoride. So ammonium fluoride also can deprotect the silyl protection. This is the example of protection of TIPS. This is a triisopropyl silyl ether, which is deprotected to OH. Okay. So this is how the silyl protection and deprotection is carried out. Friends, I have collected this information from the very nice book from Greenidge, Protective Groups in Organic Synthesis, 5th edition, and author is Peter Woods. Also, from Wikipedia, there is very nice information on the Wikipedia about silyl ether formation and their deprotection. So you can refer these two links, or this book and one link, for the further study. So this is all about the silyl protection and deprotection. I hope you understood the topic.